Hi, really excited to share a little bit more about how to serve inference requests on MI300s. And inference encompasses all of your agent workloads, all of your RAG workloads, just anything that requires LLM inference where you're hitting the model, chatting with it, whether that be on your own, running maybe an open model, for example, using the LLM, if you're hitting, you know, ChatGPT or the like, and those are served on a GPU behind the scenes, behind that API, that is inference as well. So in this video, I'll share a little bit more about the AMD MI300 GPU and exactly what benefits it provides on inference. So let's dive right in. When you're deciding on a model to use for inference, a common trade-off is between speed and accuracy. So you're thinking, okay, well, maybe I can pick a smaller model for, you know, faster speed. It'll run faster, but maybe the accuracy be lower. Its intelligence is lower. The brain is smaller. But then you can choose a larger model where you'll have greater accuracy, but the speed is slower. It's much slower because it needs to, you know, make more computations to produce a result. But what if you could get a fast large model running? Well, that's the best of both worlds. And that's exactly what we'll show you that the MI300, why it's so important, why it can really, really help with serving these fast models really, really quickly. So instead of turning off speed or accuracy, you can have the best of both worlds and fit a really large 70 billion parameter model on just a single MI300 GPU. And that is totally possible here. So you could also, of course, you know, parallelize and run 8 of these on a single node of 8 MI300 GPUs. But essentially, this is what the MI300 enables you to do. So what really is going on in a model? It's not just the 70 billion parameter part, the weights of the model taking up space on the GPU. It's also something called a KV cache, which is, you know, trying to speed up that inference for you by caching some of the computations for attention so that you don't have to recompute it because the model has already maybe seen it and stored some of those values in there. So especially when you're letting the model run inference autoregressively with these language models, so that's like one word at a time, one token at a time, a lot of the computation is the same, right? It had already seen the same chat history, for example, as it chats again with you, as it predicts the next token. So caching that is really, really effective, but you only have some memory to cache it. So first on model weights, are probably the bulk of the memory usage for Llama 3.1 70 billion parameter model in 16-bit precision or FP16. It takes up 140 gigs of memory. Whereas in FP8, which is starting to be, you know, lower precision format that is starting to show signs of being accurate enough for various applications like chat or translation and the like and summarization, we're able to take up less space, right? Only 70 gigs of memory. So this is the memory usage of Llama 3.1. And then there's also the KV cache. So basically how much computation the model's seen or that you've seen before when running the model that you want to cache. And so that's a combination of the batch size, so how many you're running in parallel, the number of tokens that you're putting through, of course, what kind of context you've put through, the number of layers in the model times the hidden dimension, hidden size, kind of the width of the model times the precision. And the two there is for the key and the value kind of being stored separately. So the KV is key value cache. And this is the intuition behind how much KV cache or what affects KV cache and what's being stored there in memory. And to give you a sense of solid numbers for Llama 3.1 70 billion parameter model for FP16, the KV cache size for 1,000 tokens is just about 1/3 of a gig. Whereas when you leverage the entire context window of 128,000 tokens, it's 39 gigs of memory. So it does definitely scale as you increase the number of tokens that you put into the context. So just to explore some concrete numbers across different model sizes, an 8 billion parameter model will use 16 gigs of memory for the weights of the model. And then for 1,000 tokens, it's only using 0.125 gigs of memory and scaling that out to 128,000 tokens, if the context window is, you know, large enough, there are 15 gigs of memory for a total memory of 28.5 gigs. And so that's with a batch size of 100 times 1,000 tokens each. So clearly you can see how that scales up with batch size and of course with the amount of context. And now going down to the next row, 70 billion parameter model, immediately the memory, the weights of the model increase quite a bit to 140 gigs. And KV cache also increases quite a bit, not maybe as much, but quite a bit still. And total memory now increases to 171.3 gigs. A 400 billion parameter model, quite large, is taking up a whopping 810 gigs of memory in its weights. And as you can see now, it really is the weights of the model that are taking up the, you know, more space in the KV cache now, but the KV cache still does influence the amount of memory needed to run the model. And what's really exciting is that the MI300 has 192 gigs of memory, high bandwidth memory, or HBM. And so it can fit that 171.3 gigs of the 70 billion parameter model with batch size of 100 and 1,000 tokens. So that's really exciting. It can fit that in just a single GPU, let alone, you know, an 8 GPU node. The MI300 is just really memory rich. So just to compare with another popular GPU from NVIDIA, the H100. So MI300 is just really special in how much memory it's able to hold. And for popular models, just to give you a sense of how much memory is required, and then, you know, the MI300 can really store all of these different models on there, and you only really need one, which is exciting because then you only have to deal with one GPU and not have to parallelize like crazy across multiple GPUs or multiple nodes. And for a GPT-3 level model, 175 billion parameters, which is quite large, you only need three of those GPUs, which fits on a single node of MI300s. There are workarounds, so you can actually split up your model across multiple GPUs. You don't have to necessarily fit it on just one. So you can split it up. It's called tensor parallelism, or TP. It does introduce a communication overhead, of course, because GPUs have to then talk to each other. There's more complexity in serving, and of course, the compute costs will go up since you're necessarily kind of distributing it in this way. And of course, you have to deal with if, you know, something goes wrong with the GPU in some way, or it reaches some kind of memory issue on any of them, might impact the entire inference load or inference request. So this, you know, this is possible. It does affect the scaling of inference, but it is a way around a GPU, like out of memory error, OOM error. Just to give you a sense of the next generation with AMD MI300 and the next generation of MI325, you get even more memory. And just to compare that with H100 and 200, it's so substantially more, right? So it makes it so that you might not even need tensor parallelism for a lot of the models that you want to run. Or you need less tensor parallelism. So to give you a sense of that here, MI300 only is using, you know, one tensor parallelism, so only one GPU here, whereas the H100, you cannot do that. It starts with TP2 down here. So the MI300 can fit this Llama 3.1 70 billion, there's 70 billion parameter model in FP8 on just one GPU. And that's really, really special because that cannot be done on other popular GPUs. So that's what that's showing here. In the meantime, other GPUs, when, you know, dealing with, you know, either larger batch sizes or the like, will start to encounter issues like out of memory issues with TP2 for the H100, or KV cache eviction in TP4 and 8 when the batch size grows beyond 128. So that's a bit of data, a bit of information on MI300 and what makes it so special, and why that increased and rich high bandwidth memory is so important and so valuable for a lot of inference serving. And if you're ready and excited about some of the things you learned in this video, go ahead and try it for yourself on the AMD Developer Cloud with one or a whole node of 8 MI300s, and you can use it on demand. Thank you.